I've been meaning to make this video since 2014, so that goes to show you how together my life is right now. I wanted to talk about the LINQ monitor implant. I've talked to a bunch of you guys about different heart problems. Some of you guys have the same IST, some people have SVT, and there's WPW and, like, I don't know, 1,000 other conditions that are very difficult to diagnose at first and can kind of all have the same symptoms initially. So the LINQ monitor is an alternative to the Holter monitor. 24, 48 hours, you got a couple leads, you leave it on, you don't shower, you go, you know, about your business. Sometimes they have a little button on it where you can mark cardiac events or symptoms. You keep a little journal, you return it to your doctor, and then they analyze it and try to put your symptoms together with what's actually going on with your heart. I've done the 30-day monitors as well, where they teach you where to put the little sticky pads, and you've got usually, that first one I had was really, really old. It was like, it looked like a beeper, and it had three leads coming off of it, and it would record, and then I would call a company and put this little box next to the landline. Nobody has a landline anymore. And it would screech, and the screeching would transmit your EKG over the phone. And then the last time I got one of the newer ones, and it came with its own little cell phone pack. So you have your main thing with all the cords and the little piece where you can actually mark on the thing where your symptoms were and what you were feeling. And then you carry a cell phone with it that transmits the signal directly to the, you know, the base center, whoever's receiving the signal. Those are designed to try and catch events that happen within 30 days. Sometimes it's not enough to collect the information they need. So that is where the LINQ monitor comes in. It sits in your chest, just under the skin, and it's close enough to the heart that it can pick up the electrical signals. I took so long to make this video, it's probably old technology, but this is the LINQ monitor. And the reason it's attached to a ribbon is because I made mine into a Christmas tree ornament, because I'm really, really weird, and it freaks people out. You can see how tiny it is, and it's implanted, the quickest procedure ever. It's kind of like microchipping a dog. I'm a vet tech, so that's like the closest thing I can compare it to. But it's a teeny incision. They close it with glue. This comes preloaded in like a what looks like a giant flat syringe. So they make the incision, and then usually they, you know, it's up here somewhere. My doctor actually implanted this on the bottom side of my left breast, and he kind of tucked it in there so that it was hidden, and I didn't have any issues with it. After the initial healing period of about a week and a half or so, it was tender, but I couldn't feel it. It didn't interfere with underwire bras or anything like that. But this sits inside, and the way that it works is there are parameters set. So if there's any arrhythmia, pauses in heart rate, if you go over a certain beats per minute or you go under, this thing will start recording. Another way that you can do it as well, and this is what I had to rely on, was they give you this little guy. You press this button, you hold it over wherever the LINQ monitor is implanted, and when you hold it, the little check mark shows up on here, an LED check mark, and this will mark on the printout, okay, I had a symptom here, and that way if the LINQ monitor didn't pick it up for some reason, it will show that I had symptoms. So that's one part. So you've got your LINQ monitor and then your little patient assistant that you keep on you all the time. I used to keep this in my scrub pocket because anytime I'd have an event, I could just pull it out, hit the button, and then put it back. And I know at the end of the day, it will transmit. So here's the other part of that. This is the base station. It sits on your end table, and it's set so that every night it sends the signal to your doctor's office with your data on it from that day. As long as you're within like 6 feet, I think, of this being in your chest, it'll transmit, and it'll tell you on the screen in the morning that it was a successful transmission. It just sends like the readout. So at night, if this just transmits normally, it'll say she had 3 events of bradycardia, a run of SVT, blah, blah, blah. It'll just kind of transcribe it that way, but if you actually pick this up and scan the monitor, it will send the full EKG to the doctor's office. This was very key in getting the data that I needed to get diagnosed. I think this thing lasts about 3 years from what I've heard, maybe longer depending on how often you're using it. It's a kind of an incredible diagnostic tool, something this small being able to last as long as it does, and it kind of gives you peace of mind to just be able to, for up to 3 years, keep this recording so that you can catch those events. Some people have pretty significant heart events, but they only happen once in a great while. It may be worth asking your doctor about it. I asked mine, and I think I was the first patient that he implanted it on because he seemed kind of giddy about implanting it. But if you're constantly going back to specialists and doctors and doing Holter monitors and they have no results, it might be a good idea to ask and see if it's something that would possibly catch the events that you're having. Like I said, implantation was super easy. I think it's something they could probably do in a doctor's office. You don't need sedation for it. It took longer to do the preparation, the sterile prep and everything, than it did to implant it. I was awake the whole time, didn't feel anything aside from the initial little lidocaine poke, and then after that it was glue, it healed in a couple days. Didn't ever notice it after it was healed, and they took it out when they put my pacemaker in. But yeah, just wanted to kind of give some information about this cool device. And then now it's a Christmas tree ornament.